Okay. Genesis 1, 13, and the evening and the morning were the third day. Now, there is an element which I have not touched on, I don't remember touching on it, that is intimately connected with the very first element in creation, and that is temperature. We haven't mentioned temperature. Is it hot or cold? I will say that the Hebrew word yom, which is translated day, is a root to be hot. So a yom is the warm part of the day, but we don't have that day yet. We don't know what day is associated with light, but light and day are two different words in Hebrew. What we have in Genesis 1 verse 3 is light, perhaps without heat. We know of such a thing in our scientific world today, light without heat, phosphorus, something that's phosphorescent. That is a light without heat. But the lack of temperature becomes important, I think, as we consider a creation of botanical life before there is the sun. We have light, but it's not, I don't know if we could say that it is a light that is connected to heat or life, life form. I don't know. All we have here is a case of this botanical life coming up out of the erets, out of the dry, the earth, which is otherwise unaccountable, other than the fact that God said, let it happen. And it's created without the sun. And I think that that's a curious note. Moving right along. Verse 14. And God said, this is still Elohim, still an unidentifiable person, and yet an agent of, the agent of this fantastic creation process here. And God said, let there be lights, plural, in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night. And let them be for signs, and for seasons, and for days and years. Well, I suddenly lost track of everything we've talked about up to this point, because this is, suddenly words mean something than what they meant before. Although we've already seen two different kinds of darkness. Two different kinds of light now. God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven. Now remember that firmament is just an expanse that separates the mayim, or the mayim, under the firmament from the mayim that's above the firmament. We don't know what that firmament is. Don't confuse the Latin firma with something solid. It's just a vast expanse of non-water. Non-water. So, in that firmament, God creates lights, luminaries, light is or in Hebrew, orim, I suppose, lights, luminous bodies, a luminary, maor is a luminary body. Light itself is a verb, actually, to be luminous, or God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night. I don't know how that's going to happen. We already have day and night. It's already divided. The light is divided from the darkness. The light is called day. The darkness is called night. And now we have lights in the firmament in the heaven to divide the day from the night. This is a bit of a challenge, but their division of day and night, the way in which they divide day from night, is apparently in addition to the already divided light and darkness. And remember, we have no shapes. We still, as yet, except for whatever shapes are implied by botanical life, which that's pretty complex. I mean, every kind of shape you can think of is implied there. But in terms of this firmament, in terms of the mayim above it and the mayim beneath it, we still don't have a specified indication of shape.